Today on Remembrance Day, remember all those people who gave their lives for us. And I just wanted to mention two of my family members, Hubert, my great-grandfather, and his son, Doug. Hubert was in World War I, and I have an extract from a letter here that was sent to his wife. Private H.H. Hill, formerly Gardener at Lord Downes Dingley, who joined 7th North Hants soon after the outbreak of the war, was gassed and wounded in the Great Battle and is at present in hospital in Nottingham. Private Edgehill, my great-grandfather, writes home, "My hand is going to be fine. I don't think I shall lose any fingers." He then goes on to write, "There's many a poor chap laid on the field, never to be picked up. There are some poor chaps who have been laying on barbed wire for months. It was awful to see them, but impossible to shift them. We had a terrible slaughter. Anyone who came out alive was lucky. 300 of our lot left, and we got off light." He then went back and was wounded again. Mrs. Edgehill, his wife, who resides in Clarence Street, has received a following letter from the chaplain. "Dear Mrs. Edgehill, I am writing to tell you that your husband has been admitted to the hospital. To save his life, the doctors have had to amputate his left arm. I am very thankful to be able to tell you, as far as I can judge, he's going to be well and is in very good spirits." Private Edgehill himself has written from the base hospital in France to his wife, "Don't worry, I'm going to be well. Consider myself very lucky indeed, as I had a halfpenny in my pocket and the bullet hit that and turned off and went into my arm. If it had gone into my side, I should have been killed instantly. So we must be thankful it was no worse." His son, Douglas Edgehill, then went on to fight in World War II. He was in the RAF. He unfortunately had an accident and was paralysed from the neck downwards and could never walk again. He did, however, get the Distinguished Flying Cross. What I have to say is many of you remember people like this. Our duty is to never forget them.
Christopher Black, Royal British Legion. For me, this is a time for taking stock, for remembering friends who didn't come home, and also for remembering those that did, many with life-changing injuries, some visible, some invisible. So what is remembrance about for me? Well, it isn't just about the youngsters who didn't come home. Every one of them had somebody at home, a sibling, a spouse, a child, and hardest of all, a parent who has outlived their child. I want the nation to remember not just the fallen, but also those who were bereaved. And to those families, I want to say, remember, we remember them as they were. We talk of them still. Not the manner of their passing, but of the things we did before. The laughs, the pranks, the trouble we got into, our brothers in arms who remain forever young. And one thing is sure, we will remember them.
My name's Paul Howarth. I'm a funeral director with Central England Cooperative Society at our funeral home in Allanton here in Derby. Remembrance for me is about a number of things. It's about remembering those that have served in the British and Commonwealth Armed Forces, for the people that have given their lives in defence of our freedoms and way of life, as well as those who lived and are still living with the memories and scars of their experiences. They should never be in any doubt of the eternal debt of gratitude this country owes them, and Remembrance Day is a symbol of this, proof that we will remember them. But it's more than this. It's a visible, visceral and inescapable reminder of the loss of life and suffering that was caused by the political and social unrest that was abound both prior to and during the Great War and the Second World War. It serves as a historical lesson to us all We cannot afford to forget how and why those events came to pass, and how working together as a local and global community is as important now for peace and our planet's future as it has ever been. It has been my honour to be involved with the veterans of Derby War Memorial Village over the years that I've been a funeral director here in Allenton. Being asked to join them in their annual parade to the war memorial and laying a wreath there during the remembrance services has been a privilege that is hard to do justice to in words. It's more a mix of feelings and emotions, of pride and humility, sorrow for the past and hope for the future. Hope that the world can use the lessons of the past to strive to be a better place for everyone.
Councillor Mick Barker from Derby City Council and the Cabinet Member for Governance. It's at this time of year I always remember my father, who was born on November 11th, 1920, long since passed, unfortunately. My dad was in the RAF and was stationed at Biggin Hill during the Battle of Britain and survived it. In latter years, I used to take him down to London to the Armistice Day Parade on Whitehall. He always loved it to see the old soldiers, and he was one of them. And it was only in latter years, as I say, when he became infirm, that we had to stop doing it. But we always remember that day, especially when it fell on his birthday, which was November 11th.
Hardyul Dinser, Police and Crime Commissioner for Derbyshire. I'm really pleased that despite COVID-19, Remembrance Sunday will be celebrated in Derby and Derby Cathedral. It was a very poignant service. Despite the troubles we are facing today, we have not forgotten those who have given their lives for our safety and peace now in the past. I thank them all for their sacrifice for our tomorrow, and I was so pleased to be part of the ceremony in remembrance with everybody else who could make it in this social distancing climate we are experiencing. Thank you for everybody who organized it. It was the right message in the right way for the right reason.
Councillor Rob Cooper, Chatterton Ward Councillor and Armed Forces Champion for the City of Derby. Remembrance to me means thinking about all those that have served our great country, past and present, those that made the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom. It's also a time to be around family and the community and think together about all the sacrifices made for us all. Particularly the people I serve with, I always think about them on Remembrance Service Days and think how they are, where they are, and for those that are no longer with us.
Thank you. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
Thank you. Please stand. We meet in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may together live in freedom, justice, and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability, and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts past and present have been given and taken away. As we remain standing, let us pause in a few moments of quiet and offer our prayers to God. Ever-living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Bible reading, Matthew 5:3-10. Jesus said to his disciples, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those that mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give us peace. For the servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God, may God give peace. God give peace. For those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss, may God give peace. God give peace. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. May God give peace. God give peace. For civilian women, children, and men whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatreds of humanity, may God give peace. God give peace. For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free, may God give peace. God give peace. For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. May God give peace. God give peace. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honor the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. Please, would you stand? Let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace? We will. Will you seek to heal the wounds of war? We will. Will you work for a just future for all humanity? We will. Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all people and live lives of justice, courage, and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you and remain with you now and always. Amen.